Ben Hatta, Madison Square Garden.
I know, this is great, isn't it?
Yeah, how have you done, have you enjoyed the wrestling thus far?
It's been fantastic. I think there's probably been more pins than I've ever seen at a national tournament, and some great upsets. I think to see teams like Virginia Tech doing really well in Mizzou is great. I think it's just been a fantastic environment. I can't wait to see how they set up the finals with that one mat in the middle of Madison Square Garden and just the crowd going crazy. I mean, when the guy who took fourth, what was his name?
Corral.
Yeah, when he took fourth and the crowd gave him a standing ovation because of the effort that he put forward, that was amazing. He got more applause for his efforts taking fourth than people were getting for winning third, and some people might even get for winning a national title. So I think it's been a fantastic time, fantastic arena. I hope to see you come back here often. So.
Looking at it, you actually live in White Plains,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, 30 minutes north of here.
And you've done things in L.A., you've worked in production, worked in film, right?
Absolutely. I lived in L.A. for 15 years working in television, and now I've moved out to New York, and I've been out here for the last 4 years working in television, so absolutely.
All right, you got a famous dad, slightly famous dad, slightly famous grandfather. A lot of people, just a long story short, your family took the sport of wrestling to the nation of Japan.
Yes, from the U.S.
On a judo tour, right?
Yes, my grandfather came here with the Japanese judo team, sparred against all the wrestling teams, realized that some of the wrestlers were beating the judo guys and that he needed to learn that sport too. And he followed them and took notes and ended up taking that back to Japan and starting the sport there. And it slowly grew and he started shipping all the good Japanese wrestlers back to the States. My dad was one of them, Yojiro Yutake, my uncle. And that's where it started. That's how we all got here.
Your dad and uncle, both NCAA champions for Oklahoma State.
Yep.
And uncle, silver medalist as well, I believe, in the World Championships.
Yes.
I mean, there's a lot of history there. A lot of history. Now, we're talking about the third major media piece on the whole Dave Schultz,
absolutely,
John DuPont, Team Foxcatcher. Obviously, the story, there's the movie, and then Prince of Pennsylvania 30 for 30. You guys are doing the third piece that's actually coming out on Netflix April 29th?
April 29th comes out on Netflix. It's called Team Foxcatcher. We actually just got accepted to Tribeca Film Festival for the official selection there. So that's going to premiere on April 18th in New York and run throughout that week at the festival. And then 2 weeks later, it's going to air on Netflix worldwide. So we're really excited about that. It's a fantastic project. It's taken us forever to do it, but it's a great story and it needed to be told. So
when we look at it, you know, the 30 for 30 is pretty good, pretty thorough, a different view. Obviously, the movie Foxcatcher is, there's some half-truths in it. The dates aren't exactly accurate, but a very dark
yes,
film, and this is a very dark story, obviously.
Yes.
But why did you guys feel like this was necessary for you guys to do a third major piece on it?
Well, it's funny because this actually started at the same time that the feature film started. So this started 6 years ago. So this was even before the 30 for 30 for ESPN. So this has just been a project in the making for a long time. The director, John Greenhall, approached the widow, Nancy Schultz, about doing the film. And she brought him on as the director. And then my buddy, Jeremy Baylor, and I, who run production companies, got involved because this is a story that just needs to be told. Dave's story was he was an amazing person, amazing individual, amazing wrestler. And it was just, it's an intense story. And there's still that unknown, you know. There's reasons and beliefs on why, you know, DuPont murdered John. And there's some of that factor of, you know, what happened. And this really breaks down the whole process and shows all the sides to what was going on in those years from 92 to 96.
Yours is called, the title is
Team Foxcatcher.
Team Foxcatcher. Prince of Pennsylvania is the other one, and then obviously Foxcatcher.
Yep.
Looking at, you know, like trying not to get muddled down and being the third film,
right,
even though you started it 6 years ago,
right,
how hard is that to get it out there and get notoriety for it?
One of the reasons that the film was being made at that time was because we knew that the Foxcatcher was also being made, the feature film. So our goal was to come out at least around or after that time to combat both stories, to have both stories come out. One's obviously a feature. There's certain liberties that are taken creatively. Ours was going to come out and tell all the truths and all the sides to it. It was one of those stories that just had so many facets to it. There's money, there's the athletics, there's dreams and aspirations from both sides, and then there's this weird sort of dementia state that happened. And I feel that the feature film, through that real part that happened at the end, in into a story that was based around Mark Schultz. The Prince of Pennsylvania also featured a little bit of that from a few perspectives of from Foxcatcher, about what happened at Foxcatcher with Dave Schultz. This tells the story from all aspects, from the widow to all the Olympic champions at the time, Kenny Munday, Kevin Jackson, Bruce Baumgartner is in it. We've got all the Team Foxcatcher wrestlers. We've got police officers, investigators, lawyers, attorneys, all those people are involved in this project. So it's going to be great. It's going to tell everything from front to back on sort of why it happened, how it happened, and, you know, what happened afterwards.
What's the length? What's the
this flow? Is a 90-minute film. So it's a feature-length film documentary, whereas The Prince of Pennsylvania was a 45-minute, and then obviously the feature film Foxcatcher was a scripted version of this and, you know, had its liberties. So this is really the meat and the potatoes of the story.
I'm super excited. When are we going to be able to watch it? Are we going to have to wait till April 29th?
You guys might have to wait till April 29th. Flow Wrestling might not have to, but the viewing audience will have to wait till April 29th.
On Netflix,
yes. It's going to be worldwide, and we should have posters out soon. They should have publicity out soon. So in the next few weeks, hopefully there's going to be a big push, and it'll be out there for everyone to see.
All right. I am going to interview your...
Yes, my roommate, Jeremy Baylor, from college, he's also a Penn wrestler. That was another thing, too, that we want to talk about. I'll let Jeremy speak to that, because he's from the finance side, about the people who were involved in the production of it. We're all from a wrestling standpoint, a University of Pennsylvania standpoint, and, you know, really all came together from the directors to the financiers to the executive producers. So, Jeremy Baylor, why don't you come on in?
All right, thanks.